But it will be warm. It'll be a little bit more humid. And this is more moisture being flung up across the area, really ahead of Eta, which we'll be keeping an eye on. Now, Tropical Depression Eta, it is back in the Caribbean over the water, still unorganized. This was as of the 12 p.m. update. Remember, our updates are a little different now that we've ended daylight saving time. But this will continue to move northeast, 6 miles per hour. Could become a tropical storm later on this afternoon, strengthen as it moves over the very warm waters here in the Caribbean, moves up towards Cuba, and then continues to strengthen. It's possible it tries to become a weak hurricane in this area, but then it's going to start to run into some wind shear, and then eventually it makes that hard west turn. Could clip South Florida, move over Florida, move south of Florida, the Keys, just somewhere in there, and then slows down as it moves into the Gulf by Tuesday here. And then by Wednesday, notice we start to get more of that northerly turn. So at the moment, the trends are this would stay east of us. Don't be surprised if we're in the cone at some point, but right now the trends are that this will probably stay just to our east. Now, there's still some uncertainty with that because of timing, and we're talking, you know, 7 days out here in the forecast, but here's what we'll be watching with the steering currents. Now, there's a trough of low pressure over the Gulf. That's what's pulling this to the northeast right now. What will happen by Sunday going into Monday? Notice this big ridge will start to build in over Florida. That's going to start to make it turn pretty hard to the west. That will steer it to the west, but at the same time, high pressure building over it means the steering currents will essentially collapse. There's not going to be a lot of things steering this as it gets in here, and then that trough and cold front will move in by the middle and end of the week, and that will start to turn this thing. So it really just depends on how far west it gets before it turns, and that will determine how close it gets to us. Right now, it looks like it will turn before it gets to us, but as I mentioned, that's 7 days out. So GFS in the red there, Euro in the green. These are our two big global models showing a similar scenario, at least through Monday. By Tuesday into Wednesday, they really diverge on what they think this is going to do. The GFS really stalls it here, kind of just hangs out off the Florida coast and weakens and dissipates as it gets shredded by wind shear. The Euro keeps a little bit more organized and moves it a bit further west and a bit more progressive with it, and that allows it to get closer to the northern Gulf Coast, but still just to our east. So that's a scenario we'll have to watch, just how much it wants to move once it gets into the Gulf. But if it stalls out, more than likely, if it does this kind of GFS scenario, it will get nowhere near us and we wouldn't even feel impacts from it. So that's a possibility with it too. As I mentioned, this would be Thursday, Friday, Saturday of next week. So we got a long time to watch it. Concern level right now, very low, put it that way. So we'll continue to keep an eye on it. We'll see some showers this weekend. Not bad going into next week. It will be warm, a little bit more humid in the lower 80s. And then by the end of next week, we could be dealing with another cold front.